Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video, we will try to talk about the combining the types with the generics. So consider I have a function which is returning a string, and you can see it is returning a string. Okay, I wanted to have another function which is returning a number. Okay. So this is accepting a number and returning number. Right. So in this case, why should I write this code two times? I mean, the same function, the only difference is it is accepting different argument and different returning the same kind of argument, right? So I can put the generics here. Generics, what it is giving us the freedom. Okay, this is the hello is a function. It is accepting some type. Okay, the same type it is accepting in the function and same type it is returning from the function. So we can write the same code like this, and it will be valid if you are calling this function for some string, if you are calling this function for some number, okay, if you are calling this function for even for boolean, all cases will be valid, right? So this is actually the generic concept in a TypeScript, and this is very much popular. So what we will do, we will try to combine, we will try to use the combination of types with the generics. So function intersect, let's call a method, or SECT, so we are trying to talk about intersection. Okay, so here this function is taking the argument t1. Okay, and I have the parameter which is being passed, which is of t1. Okay, then what it is, it can return either t1 or it can return some type a. We can define that type here. So there is an interface type a already declared. What interface is having? Interface is having a is of type string and b is of type string. Okay, so this is the function, and it can return either of same type or either a instance either of type interface. Okay, so what we will do, we are creating const x of type a. Okay, so what it need to have, it need to have both the variables a and b, and I have b which is being represented by b. Okay, both the variables are there. Now, what it need to return? It need to return either the same type t1 or either type a. So, you see the return syntax. Here, I'm putting any. So, any of object and dot assign. Because I'm trying to create a new object out of it. X is the source and t1 I'm passing. Okay, so whatever the new object I'm returning, either it can be of it will be of type A, right? Because what you are doing, X is the local object, object dot assign. How it works? If you know object dot assign, it actually is creating the new object. There you can pass some variables. X is 10, or there can be another object. Y is 20, y is 70. So this final object will have x 10 and y 70. Okay, the same thing we are doing here, we are actually combining the type. So either it can be of same type or it will be of type A object, right? Type A is having A and B, because we don't know what will be the new type will be there, because it will combine the values from t1 and x. So X is having the same type A and B as the parameters in this object, but we don't know about the T1. T1 may have some more properties, right? So either it can be of type A or either it can be of type T1. Okay, so we can also do the intersection. So a few more examples we will cover in the next video.